are you?
You know who I am. Legend cannot be killed. Yennefer's in Vizima. Got a few friends there, so... Something wrong?
Look around. Trouble brewing.
Who are they?
Patriots. Drinking their seventh round for Temeria. A fist starting to itch.
Don't see any Nilfgaardians.
They'll find another foe. I'll buy some provisions for the journey. Then we'll go. Geralt. We should stay out of it, just this once.
What happened to the lilies?
Took them down.
Took them down? To hang a golden sun there now?
I cannot show Temerian colors. They'll come and burn the tavern down.
Maybe it's true what they say. You fond of the Imperials? You Nilfgaard's whore?
I'll let that pass. I know grief eats at your heart.
No shit. They hang my sister, dragged her out the cloister like a dog. Said Nilfgaard's no place for superstition, that they don't fear the wrath of the gods. And you, do you fear it? If not for Annie, your child would have choked on its navel string. You owe your son to
Let
my sister
go.
Attending to the birth, and you don't fear the god's wrath. You don't fear it, you cunt! Leave me be!
Recognize this medallion? You know what it means. Back off.
You all right?
They say witches steal young'uns.
That true?
What the Emperor promise you, freaks? Your own land, like he did the elves once?
Get out, all of you.
We ain't going nowhere. And neither are you.
They won't back down now.
I can see that. It's over.
Leave me be! Get away!
See his face! God save us!
Be gone, and don't ever come back.
So much for not getting involved. Come on, let's go.
Started.
Excuses, excuses. You've not changed a bit.
Yen? How?
I received a report about a witcher who'd appeared in White Orchard. I knew it was you, looking for me. I might have waited until you found me, but... Well, you know me. Patience has never been my strong suit. It's... good to see you, Geralt. I'd even embrace you. Were you not covered in blood?
Sorry. Wasn't expecting to see you. To be honest, this isn't at all how I imagined we'd meet.
How did you imagine it?
You didn't imagine you'd have a Nilfgaardian escort. Don't get me wrong, Yennefer. I'm glad to see you, but I do think you owe us an explanation.
And I shall provide it. In Vizima. Ready your horses.
We can talk here. Some charming orchards nearby. In bloom, even, so you almost can't smell the corpses.
A tempting proposition. Sadly, I must say no. You see, someone awaits you in Vizima. Someone who doesn't like to be kept waiting. Emperor Emir Var Emrys. Or, to those on more intimate terms with him, the white flame dancing on the graves of his foes.
Doubt I number among that group. Far as I remember, last time we saw each other, he wanted to kill me.
Well, now he wishes to make you an offer.
The kind one can't refuse.
I didn't, though I could have.
Must have been a damn good offer then. Not many things you'd give up your freedom for, and even fewer people.
The sooner we set off, the sooner you'll find out.
What about you?
I'm going in the opposite direction. I somehow doubt the Emperor's invitation mentioned me. Besides, I've got things to do at Caremore, remember?
Yeah, I remember. Thanks for your help, Vesemir. See you soon.
How's your horse? Swift?
Can't complain. Why do you ask?
I'd like to be back behind some thick city walls as soon as possible. Knowing you, it was probably filthy.
Just the beginning. But then...
But then? Talk of this tomorrow, all right? After the audience.
This bard's tale begins near White Orchard, with my dear friend Geralt of Rivia seeking his lover of yore, the sorceress Yennefer. She'd eluded him for years, but now seemed just a few steps ahead. After many trials and tribulations, Geralt finally learned that Yen was in nearby Vizima.
It must suffice.
Thinkemir cares if I'm clean.
The gentleman will refer to his Imperial Majesty by his full title or not at all. The gentleman will be seated on the bergère.
The what now?
In that chair. Cutwin, please shave the gentleman's sideburns to half an inch.
What's wrong with my beard? Always thought it added to my dignity.
It does. Yet it also detracts from your elegance. In Nilfgaard, we consider beards hard on the eyes. Especially beards infested with lice.
Been on the road a while. Fine. Do your thing.
Tilt your head back, please, and sit still.
And prepare to answer some questions.
General, I am not certain this is the appropriate time.
I can't think of a better time. Men turn honest when they feel a blade at their throat. Morvran Voris, commander of the Alba Division. Before they take you in to see the Emperor, Witcher, there's some information I need you to verify. It's a formality, but one that must be seen to.
Sure. Paperwork's gotta be in order.
So, Geralt of Rivia. Place of birth unknown, parents unknown, age unknown. All insignificant details. Let us proceed to more recent events. The siege of La Valette Castle. The fate of the defending commander, one Arya.
We fought on opposing sides, true. Then we landed in the same dungeon. Arian escaped, set fire to the castle on his way out.
Ah. So that is how the blade started. Our reports suggested the dragon was responsible. Moving on. You then found shelter in charming Flotsam, and from there made your way to Vergen. My question is how?
Left Flotsam with Yorvith, commander of a Squirtel unit.
A slayer of monsters and a slayer of men. You forge interesting alliances.
Something tells me my most interesting is yet to come. Go on, next question, before my beard grows back in.
We shall shave you again if it does. Very well. The infamous summit at Lochmuy. You were there. And once again meddled in the affairs of the mighty.
Not at all. I meddled in a personal affair. Helped Yorvith lift the spell that held Saskia.
Yes. And in doing so, gave Radovid a reason to begin his witch hunts. Congratulations.
Nilfgaard recently started a war, unprovoked. So do us both a favor and stop moralizing.
The gentleman must sit still. I'm almost done.
I'm afraid I might find that difficult. Because, from what I know, shortly afterwards you watched a defective megascope blow your friend Sheila de Tansaville to bits.
I watched her get in the megascope, but ultimately freed her from the trap your man Letho of Gullet had set. Write that down. I want to be sure the paperwork's in order now.
Well, national interest calls on one to forge difficult alliances at times. Alliances with witches included.
That an ongoing alliance? What's Letho up to?
I had hoped you would answer that question.
Ah, so Letho's hiding from you. Must have a good reason. Was there a shift in national interest that might have caused that? I don't know where he is. Wouldn't tell you if I did anyway. Blade or no blade to my throat.
I believe that is all. Your signature, please, affirming you stated the whole truth and nothing but the truth on pain of imprisonment or death, etc., etc. Here and here.
With these formalities seen to, I would ask the general to leave the room. We shall be choosing the gentleman's attire. An important matter, but one that does not require the general's assistance.
Shame. I might have given you some advice. So long, Geralt. Good luck with your audience.
Feels more like I'm being readied for a wedding.
Were that so, I would have prepared the gentleman a frock, a tailcoat, or possibly a dinner jacket. In point of fact, the gentleman will choose from these garments.
Where are my clothes?
Where they should have gone long ago, with the laundress. They will be returned to you after the audience, clean and starched. The gentleman will tell me once he has chosen an outfit. Black suits the gentleman. Does the outfit satisfy the gentleman?
A studded doublet and a sword on my back, that's what would satisfy me. But tough, when in Nilfgaard.
Yes?
It's a saying. So what now? Powder my nose?
No need. The gentleman's complexion is light enough. The gentleman is to stand before the ruler of the North and South. I must confirm that he knows how to bow.
I'm not some boor. I know how to bow.
Please, demonstrate. That, sir, is how you might bow to a whore on a street corner, not to the Emperor of Nilfgaard. Please watch. Leg extended, hand flat, head down, chin to chest. The gentleman will rehearse.
Gotta be kidding.
Not at all. I am mortally serious. Does the gentleman know the penalty for breaches of etiquette in the Emperor's presence? 200 lashes. I do not wish that upon him, so I will not let him leave until I am confident that he knows how to behave. Lacking fluidity and grace. But we've learned to expect less of Nordlings. Come with me. The gentleman will address the Emperor only when asked to, and using the appropriate title.
Your Arch Magnificency?
I see the gentleman is in the mood for jests. I fear the Emperor might not share his disposition. Your Majesty will suffice. Spoken loudly, clearly, and with respect. Grimi eb art kerzer. Deifen aden in karn eb marvut. Emir var emreis.
Bow. Your Imperial Majesty.
Arer ep do orde.
Velien namen, vat gern favort. I thought you bowed before no man.
Didn't want to disappoint the Chamberlain. We're friends. Take it you didn't summon me to reminisce about the good old days, so...
Silence. My daughter, Cirilla, she's returned. And she's in danger. The Wild Hunt pursues her. You will find her and bring her to me.
Are you sure? Ciri left, went far, far away.
Do you believe I'd drag you here in the middle of a war to discuss a rumor?
I think anyone can be wrong, even an emperor.
I had forgotten how insolent you can be. I haven't the time to convince you, nor the desire, in fact. Yennefer will do that after the audience.
How many men in your army? 20,000? 30? So why me?
You know why. Because she trusts you.
She trusts me, yes. So tell me why you're looking for her. Doubt it's about making up for all those lost years.
For reasons of state, as always. Enough of this banter. You will agree regardless. If for no other reason than because I shall pay you more than you customarily receive for a contract. Considerably more.
Save your generosity for those whose homes your armies have raised. I'll do it for Ciri, not for your gold.
Your motives do not interest me. Only results. Yennefer will tell you the rest. This audience is finished. Meririd! Take him to the sorceress.
Follow me, if the gentleman pleases. Please keep close. There are many honorable guests in the palace, whom the gentleman...
disgusts.
Need not bother. And it's past noon.
Calm yourself.
What? Do you know who you're talking yourself to? I'm Herivard the Second, Prince of Elander. Not only am I made to wait here like some supplicant.
Radsleeten enecht es tun es saur an nein.
Es sieht efsat. Er fühlt sein
Machen. Er so hat ja. Es macht. Garen wat gern, wat kelm.
Es klauti. Kin web breine gat. En selfit den kraftbe. Es se plenten et not mache. En selfit den sigjan.
Once the gentleman is done, he should see me to retrieve his possessions.
Yes, then transcribe. The true authority in Novigrad is not the city council or the merchant's guild, but the church.
Geralt, that tunic. You look positively smashing.
Ugh, dying to take it off.
I'd consider that a proposition under different circumstances. One I might even take you up on. But we've matters to attend to. Now do you understand why I'm at Emir's court?
Mm-hmm. And seems we're in the same boat now. Ciri, she's really back? No chance he's mistaken?
Look, that's more or less what she looks like now. Or so our agents claim. Our little witch has grown into a young lady.
That. She's grown up.
It's been years since you trained together at Kaer Morhen. A great deal has changed.
You haven't. Not a bit.
I missed those awkward compliments of yours. But let's focus on Ciri, all right?
Right. Emir said the Wild Hunt's after her. I'd find that hard to believe before what happened yesterday. How did they track us down?
Because of me. You see, I've spent months searching for Ciri, using locating spells, haruspicy, geomancy, anything, really. I knew the Wild Hunt might sense it, perhaps even find me, but I thought I'd tricked them.
Well, guess you were wrong.
I've sensed them on my trail, hunting me, for some time. If not for you and Emir's soldiers, they'd have gotten what they were after. I can't risk another encounter like that. It's time to put away the magic, turn to more traditional methods. To the best tracker I know. You must find her, Geralt. before the Wild Hunt does.
The Wild Hunt? What could it want from Ciri?
I've no clue, Geralt. Might have written them to ask, but I don't have their address. I know as much as you do. It must be about her blood. Her gift. As for what the Hunt wishes to do with that gift, I'd prefer not to think about it, really.
So where's Ciri been seen, exactly?
In two places. Velen and Novigrad. The trail in Velen is most promising. You should make that your first stop. Ask for a merchant named Hendrik at the inn at the crossroads. One of the Emperor's agents. He should get in touch with you.
That's it? No passwords? Secret handshakes?
None. Sorry to spoil your fun. Your boyhood fantasies about the crafts of the trade. All we have in Novigrad are unconfirmed reports, rumors. But there you will have the help of our mutual acquaintance. Triss Merigold. Apparently she's got a cozy flat on the main square.
Sure she'll be delighted to see me. What about you? What will you do?
I shall sail for Skellige. There was a magic explosion there recently, blew half a forest down. I believe this had something to do with Ciri. I'll be in Caer Trold. Join me there once you've learned something.
One thing before we go. Why didn't you contact me? Didn't need me? Didn't even want to see me?
I didn't want to spoil things. I'd heard you and Triss made a great couple.
Yen, I'd lost my memory.
Really? That's your excuse? Let's drop it, all right? It's not what you think, or it helped me understand how much I love you. I don't wish to hear it. Any of it.
Guess this means we need to split up again. Not my preference, but I understand. Clock's ticking.
It is indeed. So why don't I teleport you to Velen, get you there at once?
Not gonna happen. I'll go on horseback, as soon as I can get changed.
Have it your way? Oh, and you really look quite dashing in black velvet.
Think so? Maybe I can have some of my armor lined with it. Good luck, Yen.
Same to you. And if you wish to learn what's happened in the world while you and Vesemir roamed the wilderness, talk to Ambassador Vaartra. That's him over there. And Geralt, I know it's wartime, but try not to be a hero, all right? Just check those leads and come back to me, in one piece. I shall be waiting.
I have no time. Squess.
How might I serve the gentleman?
By returning my things.
Citrus and cloves. The fragrance will keep the gentleman's robes fresh somewhat longer.
Thanks, bunches.
The Emperor is not known for his patience. He wants his daughter back, safe and sound, as soon as possible.
Yeah, mention something of the sort. So long.
I am Medetta, Estreth S.N. Novichok.
Yennefer were reunited, but something even more important happened in Vizima. Geralt learned that Cirilla, his one-time ward, had returned from afar, and she was in danger. He was to find her, at the Emperor's command and Yennefer's behest.
Come on. Unbind me, before the next ones come!
When they come, I'll tend to them. Meanwhile, let's you and me chat. Like to know who I'm untying.
John Verdon. Served in the 10th Maribor Division.
Long way from your army.
Me army don't exist no more. Black One smashed it to bits. I scarpered off into the woods just before that happened. Join a group of refugees. Fucking bursting with patriotism, they were. As soon as they learned I'd abandoned Temeria in her hour of need, they beat me down. Tied me up like a turkey, left me to the drowners.
Fine, I'll help.
Oh, thanks. For a minute there, I was almost sure you'd leave me to die. I'd like to thank you somehow, but I've not a chip crown to my name.
Tough. I'll take the loss.
Thanks, Witcher. May you prosper on the path.
Go, go.
Strangers coming! Run for your lives!
I'll not give her up! Not on me life!
They hear her screaming! They'll kill us and take her
home! Looking for a man. Goes by Hendrik.
What do you want with him?
Want to talk to him.
What about?
Give me a bottle of something strong.
You gotta go. I'll open the back way for you.
Haven't finished my drink yet.
Innkeep, vodka.
Who's this in?
Brave warrior, looks like. Got two swords, see?
Oi, great boy. What's the point of having two swords?
Wonder if he keeps an extra prick in his trousers too.
You fucking deaf? Gonna say who you are? Or do I need to loosen your tongue with me knife?
How about I buy everybody around?
Why would you?
Got the coin for it. Simple as that.
I don't drink with strangers.
We share a round, won't be strangers anymore. Then we go our separate ways.
And which way might yours be?
Is it just me, or is that none of your fucking business?
I must be hearing things.
You ain't. He meant to insult.
I'll have to kill him then.
You'll die, scum! Together, now!
You're a gunner!
That's enough of that.
Have you any idea what the Baron will do when he learns of this butchery? The village! He'll tear it apart before anyone can say it was some wandering mutant done it. An iron fist he's got!
Where's Hendrik?
You deaf! Understand what I'm saying? Baron won't let this stand!
Calm down. Your Baron's no idiot. Seriously doubt he'll think you locals cut his men down with farming implements. Now where's Hendrik?
Man lives in Heatherton.
Don't know where that is.
Other side of the hill. Looked that away this morning, saw a strange glow. Imperials on the right, perhaps. But who knows?
Anything else you can tell me about Hendrik?
Odd fellow. Arrived from who knows where and for no apparent reason. Shacked up with a widow whose husband was stabbed for a scrap of bread.
Baron's men don't like strangers.
Aye, and he stays out of their way. Always seems to know when they're coming. Always manages to disappear.
Thanks, innkeep.
Go out the back. More of the Baron's men in the village.
No need to worry about me.
I'd rather you not make any more trouble for yourself. For us both.
Sick black ones being
God
sent to
bless
Tamir.
Me.
Word is,
come on.
The whole village is near for Seymour. Then they cut up the sick while they stop.
strange, like dropping into a deep cellar on a hot day. And the mist.
Be whoever you is. Get away!
Calm down. It's over.
Aye. It's over. All's past, never to be restored. I'll not forget that ever.
Looking for a man named Hendrik, supposed to live in this village.
Aye, he did. No longer. They nabbed him in that hut. If you'd have heard the cries, sir. If you'd have heard how a man can scream, how he can suffer.
Tell me what happened here, step by step.
They took him. Took them all. The sun was waning, see, and the dusk went crimson like blood. Thought to myself, strange, the tones, I cannot hear them. He could do naught but moan. Here long, the terrors. Yet the village froze like in the heart of winter.
You in that hut when they rode off?
No, and I'll not set foot there. Never.
Farewell, and peace of mind to you. Just wonderful. Tortured him. Maybe they missed something. Maybe hit something in his jerkin. Damn, he's cold as ice. Nothing here. Need to check his pockets. Trousers are stiff. As if hung out to dry midwinter. Should check his boots. Blood congealed. Key hidden in his boot. Gotta fit a keyhole. Somewhere nearby, hopefully. There's a draft. Gotta be a space under this rubble. Guess I should do some cleaning. Ledger. Payment for a sack of grain. Amount due for a charcoal shipment. Hendrik was masquerading as a merchant. What's this? Notes among the ledger entries. Clever. Interesting headings. Missing and wanted. Subject appeared in Skellige. Also sighted in Novigrad. Appearance unchanged. Ashen hair, scar on her face. Avoids contact with others. Drunken swine. So-called Baron hosted subject at his castle. Or should I say, illegally appropriated fort. Reason unknown. Talk to Baron at Crow's Perch. Clashed with a witch. Subject landed in swamp. Encountered a witch. Conflict ensued. Cause unknown. Find the witch. Talk to the peasantry. Village of Midcops. Caution advised. I'm being observed. Don't know by whom or why. Unsettling signs. Dog ran off. Water in bucket froze solid. Strange glow observed in the sky. Ill omen, peasants say. Somehow they learned Hendrik was looking for Ciri, thus the torture. I'm too late. My only leads, the Baron, and some witch. Damn.
many enter.
Now! He can't take this! Now you've got my fucking...
Concern.
Need to talk to him. Open the gate.
Not a chance.
We heard what happened at the crossroads.
We'll not let a man like that in here.
Won't get in that way. Gotta find another. I'll look among the villagers. Might find one brave enough to help me. How about that? It's a tired old man not to panic and run when I appear. Greetings.
Greetings to you.
Other villagers all scurried off soon as they saw me. You didn't.
Oh, I'm too old to scurry. Besides, what could you do to me? Kill me? Go ahead. I've not long to live. Tan me hide wouldn't work. My skin's right brittle.
Lived here long?
Since I was born. Reckon that'll be more than 70 winters.
Must know the area well.
Not bad.
Listen, I gotta get inside the fortress. Can I do that without going through the front gate?
You can, but few know the way. If you were to make an humble offering, call it to this humble man, maybe I could point you in the right direction.
Don't really feel like arguing with the guards.
Years back, when the old lord still ruled Crow's Perch, the blacksmith's boy went missing. Old village looked for him. No luck. Finally found the boy in the river. He drowned.
Tragic. But how's that supposed to help me?
A few days on, an old woman who served the lord found the boy's cap near the castle well.
So, either he lost it there or he fell in the well.
Clever man. Village folk built a shrine where they found the lad's body, northwest of here. Wait till you find an entrance to a passage nearby.
Shrine? Where is it exactly?
Track that weaves through the village. Follow it to the bridge. Turn right past that. Then go on, straight as piss, till you get to a crossroads. Turn right again. Then follow that path up a hill. Shrine stands upon it.
Right past the bridge, then right again. I'll find it, thanks.
Run, Roach.
You're a man well traveled, so tell me, should I beat me when you're on speed? Rough.
Faster. Shrine. passage must be somewhere around here.
Emphysema? Now those were balls. Attended a few, me and my Annie. Oh, how we danced, how we twirled, ha ha ha!
Ooh!
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, hey!
Enough. I don't care how you do it, but the deliveries must be weekly.
Won't you stay for tea?
No. Besides, you've another guest.
Aha! A defender of the downtrodden. Greetings.
News gets around quick.
That it does. When I learned you'd slaughtered my men, I thought to have you captured and hanged. Or at least flogged. But then I thought, one tough cocker if he bested that lot of cutthroats. Man like him could prove useful.
Useful? How?
That's the spirit. We'll work well together. I can see that already. This way. One thing. You'd do well to behave this time. Remember, I've still to decide what to do with you. Which I shall do after we've spoken. Make yourself at home. Hey, where'd I put the bloody vodka? Ah, there it is. A snifter.
Why not?
Ha! A man after my own heart. With Foltes dead and Natalis whereabouts unknown. Bloody hell. Who's a loyal Temerian to drink to these days?
Himself and his company?
Good enough. To the matter at hand. I'm Philip Strenger. Now the Blobtits round here call me the Bloody Baron.
Geralt of Rivia. Blobtits call me the Butcher of Blaviken.
I know who you are. Truth be told, it's the only reason we're talking. How do you like it here in Velen?
Didn't come here to talk about the scenery.
You're wrong to avoid the topic. You've just arrived, plain to see. And the local swamps and bogs, they're interesting to say the least. Someone loses their way around here, it becomes damn hard to find.
What are you getting at?
Many have lost loved ones here. Some their wives, others their daughters.
What's that supposed to mean? That a threat?
Aye, not as clever as I suspected you'd be. No, it's no threat. I'll spell it out for you. I know who you're looking for. She showed up some time ago, exhausted, wounded, and stinking like a soaked hound after a hard hunt. Later, I learned she'd come from the swamp. Said some beasts from the woods attacked her before she could reach the village.
Calm down. Hello there. Are you lost?
A little, I guess. Are you?
Yes. Though also just a little.
Does that mean you know which way to go?
Not quite. Not yet, but I'm sure we'll find the way if we set off together.
What happened to you?
This? It's nothing. How did you wind up here?
My father brought me. Told me to follow the trail of treats and eat my fill. He said he would wait. So I started down the trail. Then I saw a butterfly, and I ran to catch it. And I lost my way.
Your father, why did he have you follow the trail of treats? Do you know?
Because we had nap to break our fast with.
I don't understand.
It was naughty. Broke a jug. Spilled all our milk.
Your parents must have been angry.
Mother said I should be spanked. But father said wouldn't do no good. Too many mouths to feed anyway. Sending me down the trail of treats, that would solve things.
You and your father, when did you leave home?
This morning.
And did the sun warm your face or your back?
It warmed my back.
So we must go east. Come, I'll walk you home. And explain to your parents that they must not lose their children in the woods.
We can't go home because of the Wolf King and his pack.
No kings among wolves.
These have one.
And you've seen him?
Yes. I mean, no. From behind a tree. He was huge, with giant eyes and great fangs, and he was terribly, disgustably horrific.
See what I've got on my back? Wolves fear it. Kings do too. Come, I'll help you up.
Ugh.
Massacred. Something with immense claws.
You can come out now.
Am I your brain? My father can even do that.
Mine could do a lot more. Come.
Look! There's something there.
Wait here. Don't come any closer.
But...
No buts. Stay here. I must see something. Bloodshot, but still moist. He died recently. Lips parted and bloated. Bit clear through his tongue. Immense pain before death. His chest is crushed. Ribs probably pierced his lungs. Something picked him up and threw him against the tree. Something tore his leg off. No. Gnawed it off.
Ew, that's horrible.
Stay there, and look away.
What's this? An arrow's missing. Interesting. Let's see. His liver's gone.
Why are you digging through his belly?
Would you mind making certain your laces are tied?
The Wolf King's no fantasy, it seems. Except he's a werewolf.
What happened to him?
He had a fall.
I bet. The Wolf King got him.
When did children get so smart?
What will we do when the Wolf King finds us?
Good question. I've no silver, but I can make a blade oil.
Oil? You mean like we make from rapeseed?
No. A far more special oil. Of dog tallow, wolf's bane, fool's parsley, and wolf's liver. The Wolf King will feel terrible, terrible pain.
You're smart. How do you know these things? Did your father teach you?
Not my father. My uncle. Uncle Vesemir. Often send their children out to follow the sweets.
Sometimes they send their children. Sometimes they go themselves.
Do they return?
No. Why would they? They've plenty to eat where the path ends. This way. Through the cave.
You lead.
Dark.
Afraid?
Are you?
No.
Then I'm not either. Now do you believe me?
I do. Hide!
Give him a drubbing. Never seen anything like it.
Girl, you can come out now. Come on. You're lucky we came this way. Found someone far less fortunate in the forest.
Aaron, must be. We was returning from Midcops when the brute attacked. I managed to flee, but Yaren,
the little one. No details. You have bandages at home. Some spirit? He laid a claw or two on me, unfortunately.
I've not, miss, but my lord, he's a powerful man. He's sure to help you. Might even reward you for cutting the werewolf down.
Very well. Lead us to your lord.
Just who do you think you brought me, man? That's not me daughter.
And the little one?
Neither, dammit! I think I'd know my own child.
Well, it might not be yours, the older one, but you've got to admit the likeness. That's downright striking. So, any chance for that reward?
You'll not see one fucking copper. Get out before I set my hounds on you. So, stew any good?
Very. Thank you. I'd not eaten in...
Clear to see. I'm pleased you like it. Had them prepare a bath for you once you've eaten. And you could do with some sleep. Gretka in the nook behind the hearth. You in the guest room opposite the kitchen.
Thank you.
Eat now. We'll speak once you've rested. So I ordered my men to watch her, and left her to rest.
And?
Ah, a topic for another time.
The little girl who showed up here with Ciri, what happened to her?
Gretka. She's safe and sound, helps out in the kitchen. Ciri told me of the girl's parents, what they decided. So I decided not to send the lass home. She's fed here. A roof over a warm corner she calls her own. She wants for nothing.
What happened to Ciri?
I've told you already. A topic for another time.
No, a topic for now. Talk.
That sharpness. Watch your tone, Witcher. Remember you owe me. Butchered some of my better men. We wish to come to an agreement, do we not?
Take it you won't give me this information for free.
Sharp you are.
I regret your loss. Commiserate. But you see, it so happens my wife and daughter are missing as well. I propose an exchange. Find my loved ones, and I shall tell you about the girl you seek. All I know.
Thing is, can I trust you? What guarantees do I have?
None whatsoever. Only my word.
What if I refuse? Because I just don't want to.
Would you tell me to sod off? Go ahead, but then I'll tell you the same. And what'll that make us? Two helpless, empty-handed sods. Think of it as searching for your own daughter. Ought to go quickly, then.
When do you see them last?
They vanished after the new moon, as if whisked away by shadows.
What do you mean, vanished?
Precisely that. I awoke one morn to find them gone.
You try to search for them?
Sent men out right away, but they're not suited to it. It's one thing to rip up floorboards in search of a peasant's last sack of grain. Finding a living person, they just don't know how. Besides, Velen's naught but swamps and marshy woodland. Plenty of hard to find nooks. If you're looking to hide someone, this is the place.
Maybe they were kidnapped. Got any enemies?
None worth mentioning. Worthless little pricks and angry peasants is all. None would dare raise a finger against my family. Any who might have, they've been eating dirt long since.
I'll need to know a lot more than that. Can I see their rooms?
What for?
I need clues. Anything to latch onto.
I'll not let a stranger pour through their belongings.
Want me to find them or not?
I do.
Then let me work.
Fine. But I shall go with you. The doors are locked. When she was a babe, my daughter loved animals. Saw a deer trophy on a wall once. Do you know what she asked?
Haven't got a clue.
Papa, is that deer's womp on the other side of the wall? You see it there? What's a trophy? I pity any bastard who's hurt her. I'll flay him alive. Here it is. Damn it! Jammed again. Bedchamber. Tamara's room is there.
I need a good plow.
Try not to make a mess. For their return, I want everything to be as they left it.
Wooden candlestick. Stem's broken. Fresh flowers. He expects them to return any minute. Takes hope. Walls a different color. Something used to hang here. That painting? Right size. The Baron and his wife. Look happy enough. What's this? Gotta wonder who wanted to hide the hole. And what's on the other side. It gets interesting. Piece of wood looks like the stem of that candlestick. No coincidence there. Fight might have happened here. I'll look for clues. Huh. Rest of the candlestick. And wine stains. Somebody smashed a bottle. From Toussaint. Yeah. Avarus. Scent hasn't died. Wonder where it'll lead me.
What do you seek here, vagrants?
Damn, trail breaks off. Could find something else, though.
You, white one. Looked like you got soused last night, too.
Spruce wood. Smells of juniper incense. Some sort of folk talisman. Protective. Question is, against what? Won't find much else here.
Could use some hair of the hound. Got any vodka?
Done poking around.
Whole landing smells of wine. Tell me anything about that?
One of the lads, must be. Lushies, one and all.
Give your men Ervalus?
Oh, damn it. I might have spilled it. I told you I was good and marinated that night. What does it matter? Stench of wine in plenty of corn around the castle.
Found signs of a fight in the room. Know anything about that?
A fight? What are you talking about?
Someone was attacked. Probably your wife or daughter. Whoever it was tried to defend themselves with a candlestick. Missed the attacker. Punctured the wall instead. They tussled, too.
I don't know nothing about this. That night, I was drunk. Don't remember a thing. They were gone by the time I awoke.
Doubt you were the only ones in the castle. Maybe one of your men heard something?
3 times I asked those bastards if they'd seen anything, heard anything. Nothing! Not a one of them!
Recognize this amulet?
Yes. Anna began wearing it a time ago.
Any idea where she got it?
None.
Any witches or cunning women in the area?
A Pella. Old Coot lives near Blackbow. And there's a cunning woman in Midcops, but I know little about her. She's only recently arrived. If Anna were to see someone, she'd choose the Pella, not the woman. Anna was wary of strangers, newcomers.
Ought to have a chat with this Peller.
Fair warning, he's a hard man to talk to. Rumor has it, he killed his own father with an axe as a lad, then went batty. Now they say he sees ghosts and plows his goat.
Not really interested in his hobbies. Just want to ask about the amulet.
Good plow.
White one, look like you got sacked last night.
You, white one, think your 2 swords could take on 40?
His plowing been in there an hour already.
Fancy a gander at our little stockpile. We've gathered ourselves quite the collection. Why let such nice things waste away in peasant halls?
Show me what you got.